Hello everyone, welcome to iExamB. Today in this video, I'll be discussing about some of the important provisions with respect to the trade related laws, जो कि हमारे ECGC exam के लिए बहुत important है. The chances of the questions coming from these areas is more in comparison to the other provisions, so we'll be looking on to that. इसके पहले हमने अपने previous video में discuss किया था what to study or what are the important provisions with respect to the customs law. तो वहाँ पे भी मैंने important provisions chapters आपको बताए थे, डिस्कस किया था. इन केस इफ यू हैव मिस टू वॉच दैट वीडियो, यू कैन गो टू द लिंक ऑफ दैट वीडियो व्हिच इज देयर इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो. तो अगर आपने मिस कर दिया है तो आप उसको देख सकते हो. यू रिमेम्बर टू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस ऑन द बेल आइकन सो दैट यू कैन स्टे ट्यून्ड एंड स्टे अपडेटेड. कोई भी क्वेश्चंस हो, क्वेरीज हो या कोई भी क्लैरिफिकेशन आपको चाहिए विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एनी ऑफ द कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स, यू कैन अप्रोच टू अस थ्रू दिस ईमेल आईडी व्हिच इज डिस्प्लेड ऑन द स्क्रीन और यू कैन इवन कॉल अस ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर नंबर. एज आई ऑलरेडी मेंशन कि ECGC PO लीगल का जो एग्जाम है 2023 का, इट इज इन द नेक्स्ट मंथ. सो विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू दैट, हमें क्या एरियाज हैं ट्रेड रिलेटेड लॉज में, व्हाट आर द थिंग्स वी शुड फोकस अ लिटिल मोर इन कंपैरिजन टू द अदर प्रोविजंस, दीज आर सम ऑफ द लॉज विच आर डोमेन स्पेसिफिक लॉज आप कह सकते हो, जो कि ECGC के एग्जाम्स में ही इनसे रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन पूछे जाने की प्रोबेबिलिटी ज्यादा है. तो ट्रेड रिलेटेड लॉज में बहुत सारे प्रोविजन है, बट एग्जैक्टली व्हाट थिंग्स यू शुड फोकस मोर इन कंपैरिजन टू अदर्स, जहां से कि जैसा मैंने आपको ऑलरेडी बताया, चांसेस ऑफ क्वेश्चंस कमिंग फ्रॉम दोज एरियाज इज मोर. नाउ मूविंग ऑन टू आवर डिस्कशन, सबसे पहले हम देखेंगे जो एक्सिम बैंक ऑफ इंडिया एक्ट 1981 है, व्हाट इट एक्चुअली इज. तो मैंने आपको प्रीवियस वीडियो में भी बताया था कि जब भी आप कोई एक्ट पढ़ रहे हो, नोइंग द ऑब्जेक्टिव, नोइंग द बेसिक लाइक द डेफिनेशंस एंड ऑल इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, क्योंकि वो आपका फाउंडेशन ले करेगा जिसपे आपको जो भी प्रोविजन है उस पर्टिकुलर एक्ट के समझ में आएंगे. अगर हम यहाँ पे एक्सिम बैंक ऑफ इंडिया एक्ट की बात करें तो दिस इज व्हाट इट इज अ law which is talking about or it is dealing with the provisions related to what? The establishment of the Export Import Bank of India, which is Exim Bank also, which we refer. And us particular bank ka jo Export Import Bank of India hai, uska basically establishment kyun zaruri hai, why is it needed? So basically it is for providing financial assistance to whom? To wo exporters or importers ko provide karega and for what purpose? For functioning as the principal financial institution, for coordinating the working of the institutions which are engaged in the financing of the export and import of goods and services with a view to promoting the country's international trade. So, आप देख सकते हो ये जो Exim Bank of India Act है, इसका first and foremost जो important objective है, वो ये है कि Export Import Bank of India का establishment किया जाए. किस लिए किया जाए? ताकि financial assistance provide किया जा सके exporters और importers को. और ये bank जो है, it can act or function as the principal institution जो कि coordinate करेगा with various institutions that are actually engaged in financing the export of and import of goods and services, and all these will be done with the very objective of what? Promoting the country's international trade. Next, agar hum baat kare Foreign Trade Development and Regulation Act, which is 1992. So basically this act is providing for all the laws relating to the development and regulation of what? Foreign trade, by facilitating import into and augmenting exports from India. Now moving on to the specific provision. तो सबसे पहले हम एक्सिम बैंक ऑफ इंडिया की बात करेंगे, इसके कौन कौन से प्रोविजंस ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है इन कंपैरिजन टू द अदर प्रोविजंस, वेयर द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस और चांसेस ऑफ क्वेश्चंस कमिंग फ्रॉम दीज एरियाज इज मोर इन कंपैरिजन टू अदर्स. तो अगर हम उसकी बात करें तो आप देख सकते हो, मैंने आपको बिगनिंग में ही बताया और प्रीवियस वीडियो में भी बताया था कि कोई भी एक्ट ऑब्जेक्टिव और डेफिनेशन सेक्शन जो है बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, क्योंकि वो आपका फाउंडेशन ले करेगा, बेसिक्स आपको क्लियर करेगा जिसपे कि आप वो पूरे एक्ट को समझ सकते हो, लॉ को समझ सकते हो. नेक्स्ट इज चैप्टर 2 which is talking about the establishment of this particular Exim Bank and its incorporation. So establishment and incorporation of the bank, the various provisions related to it is dealt under this particular chapter 2 under section 3 and 4. Next is chapter 3 which is covering section 5 to 9 or isme basically management of the Exim Bank se related provisions hai, how it will be managed and all those aspects that have been covered. Next is chapter 4 covering section 10 which is business of the Exim Bank, so what all business the bank is involved into. Next is chapter 5, that is section 15 to 20 jo ki export development fund ki baat kar raha hai. So export development fund jo hai basically isse related provisions is particular chapter mein covered hai aur in sare sections mein covered hai, how this fund is basically to be established or it is being initiated by the government of India and it is basically for providing what? Financial assistance for going ahead and supporting the exporters or export oriented business etc. or for expanding you can say or the development of the international market, trade, etc. And lastly is chapter 10, which is covering section 21 to 24, which is talking about the general fund and the accounts and audit. All those provisions or aspects have been covered under this particular section. Now moving ahead, we can look at the various important provisions related to the Foreign Trade Development and Regulation Act, which is 1992. And so the important provisions under this, you can see is section 2 as common, the definition provision. Then chapter 2 is talking about powers of the central government to make order and announce foreign trade policies. So foreign trade policies are related to the powers and government key, central government key, going ahead and making the orders with respect to the foreign trade policy and announcing, all those have been covered under section 3 to 6. Then chapter 3 ki agar hum baat kare, jo ki section 7 to 9 cover kar raha hai, and isme basically jo hai importer exporter code number or license related provisions hai. So the various aspects related to the code number and license is being dealt under this particular chapter. Then chapter 3A jo hai section 9 ko basically cover kar raha, and it is talking about the quantitative restrictions. So basically isme aapko various provisions related to the limit etc. on the amount of quantities and that can be actually exported or imported, that has been dealt under this. Chapter 4 jo hai section 10 to 14 cover kar raha hai, jisme search, seizure and penalty and confiscation se related jo hai provisions covered hai. Those aspects are also to some extent important, so you can go ahead and understand those provisions also. Then chapter 4A is covering section 14A to 14E, or isme control on export of specified goods, services and technology se basically related aspects hai. Kuch specified goods hai, services and technologies hai, jinka jo hai export related aspects jo hai covered is chapter mein. Lastly chapter 5 covering section 15 to 17, jisme appeal and review se related provisions, the authorities and all that has been basically covered. With this, I'll be coming ahead with other important areas with respect to the ECGCPO legal exam, jo ki wahan pe aapko kaun kaun se chapters ya provisions zyada important hai jo aapko cover karne hi chahiye for this particular exam. But before I end the video, main aapko update dena chahti hu ki ECGCPO legal ka online course jo hai iExam bhi provide karti hai, and as of now 35% off is going on, for which you can use this particular code and you can get yourself enrolled in this course. Benefit is course ka aapko ye milega ki yahan pe aapko expert faculties milenge who can provide you guidance with respect to the exam, how to go about it, how to study, what to study, all those areas can be clarified. So stay tuned to the channel for many such updates.